1034 on the phones. 81333. Start your text message with the word Devon. Now, over 100 people have objected to plans for a new industrial and business park in a Devon village. A developer wishes to build the park in Liverton and says it could create between 200 and 400 jobs. But many villagers say this scheme is inappropriate in a rural area and also argue that there's lots of employment space locally already. Sophie Pearce reports.
Well, I'm just by Benedict's Bridge Garage here in Liverton, looking over to this vast green field, which is where this business park would be. And there's already something called the Little Liverton Business Park, which is there, which it would be next to. And back in 2018, a lorry from that park crashed into Richard Ray's house, and he lives literally just a stone's throw down from where I am now.
It was early in the morning, we were still in bed, and there was an almighty crash outside, and the house shook. If anyone had been walking by at that time, I'm sure they would have been killed. The lorry that crashed into our house came from Little Liverton Business Park. If this new development went ahead, which is considerably larger, the impact for the health and safety of all the residents would be greatly increased.
Ian Roach is a planning consultant who is representing the applicant.
Well, we understand people's concerns, absolutely, but we have prepared a transport assessment and submitted that with our planning application, and that has been verified by Devon County Council Highways and Highways England, and we're reassured that there aren't going to be significant traffic impacts. I should also say that a lot of people have expressed concern about the proximity of the site to the nearby primary school. Now, we'll be creating a brand new access which should be over 400 metres away from that school. It won't go through the existing business park, which is opposite the school.
Residents, though, remain worried. There are other issues, building on a greenfield site and the effect on wildlife. Adrian Patch is a local independent councillor and says there are empty units at nearby Heathfield. The British ceramic tile factory is being adapted for new employment space. Plus, there's a new business development at Drum Bridges. He says the site is unnecessary, but the developer disagrees.
Put this in context, this Monday, Teignbridge councillors were briefed by our chief finance officer. They're looking at a 25% increase in unemployment and 25% of local businesses perhaps going bust. So as well as having an oversupply of capacity, who knows what's going to happen to demand for these units? It's likely to drop off a cliff. And this is a greenfield site that is not in the local plan.
There's a significant need for additional jobs in Teignbridge. The local plan allocated all sorts of sites across the district for employment development, but unfortunately that hasn't been delivered for various reasons. They're seeking to deliver 12,000 square metres every single year. With that not delivering, there's been a significant and chronic shortfall across the district. So this will make a positive step in redressing that.
The application will be considered by members of Teignbridge's planning committee this week. The chair of the parish council, Mervyn Wills, remains unconvinced by the arguments in favour of the scheme.
We don't feel that this is appropriate. We've got wildlife, otters in particular, in the brook beside it. Recently we've had rainfall and a large proportion of the field was flooded. We've had lots of public meetings and lots of feeling. Because at the end of the day, myself and many residents have moved to this area with green fields around us, and all of a sudden one applicant is coming along and putting an industrial estate on the edge of it, and there isn't actually any need for it.
That's the chair of the parish council, Mervyn Wills.